अनंत कोटि ब्रह्मांड नायक राजाधिराज योगिराज परब्रह्म श्री सच्चिदानंद सद्गुरु साईनाथ महाराज की जय।
ओम साई राम। SaiYugNetwork.com is a team of dedicated devotees of Lord Sai Baba who has come forward to make this Kali Yuga as Sai Yug. They have various network of blogs wherein recent experiences of devotees, history translations, spiritual ventures, divine discourses on Lord Sai Baba are shared and reached to masses around the globe. From 11 years, the service is being done via blogs and social media. Now they have entered this world of YouTube videos, specially for those who are unable to read write-ups shared. One can listen to experiences, translated stories, prayers, ventures, original bhajans, poems, quotes with beautiful pictures of Lord Sai Baba. Kindly subscribe to our channel and hit bell icon to get notification of our latest videos. Also like, share and comment to increase our encouragement. Devotedly presented by Sai Yug Network team.
Sai Baba ki jai.
Devotee experience with Sai Baba part 2. Sai sister Rashmi. Sai sister Rashmi ji from India says, as soon as the dates for our journey to the Param Dham were approaching, my worries and anxieties were increasing. On one side, I used to be worried about the difficulties we may face on the way as the journey was planned by train, which takes about 22 hours to Kopargaon Station from Delhi. We were about to travel by sleeper class with our two children, age 4 and 10, and an aged mother-in-law. This was the first time our children were able to travel by train, that too for such a long journey, and we could not even get AC coach in spite of booking 3 months in advance. My 4-year-old son falls sick very often. He gets throat and stomach infections frequently. We were worried as he got infection again before 6 days of the departure date and was continuing antibiotics till we left Delhi. Secondly, I was too worried about my meeting with Baba on our last visit to Shirdi in 2008. I somehow could not feel the proximity and spiritual connection between me and Baba, though I used to feel myself very close to Baba in Delhi. But gradually in these 4 years, facing many ups and downs in life, and especially after subscribing to Hetalji blog 2 years ago and reading various experiences of other devotees during this period, especially related to Shirdi visit, I started to realize that I could not feel the bliss in Shirdi because I do not stand anywhere comparing the love and devotion other Sai brothers and sisters have for our beloved Baba. Whenever I would think about our upcoming visit to Shirdi, I would feel butterflies in my stomach, thinking whether Baba will bless me now. Am I evolved enough to feel His presence there? Will Baba establish the spiritual connection, me and Him? Though Baba has been extending His helping hand always, and His blessings have been endless. Some of them I have covered in my yesterday's post, but the desire to have His blessings in Shirdi was killing me. All my questions to Him concerning the visit would answer, as your good fortune is coming. Why do you worry? You will have a chance to meet saintly people, etc. All His answers were positive, but my human mind was very worried. Our journey finally started on 10th October and we didn't have a single problem on the way. As soon as we checked in the hotel, noon aarti started in the temple. The hotel was 2 minutes walking distance from the temple and the aarti could be heard clearly. We rushed to our room and saw live aarti on TV. I had a desire to see Baba in purple color. When I see him first and Baba was looking too beautiful in purple on TV, I was too happy. We decided to refresh ourselves and go for Darshan after lunch as lines were expected to be shorter around 3:30 p.m. I learned from experiences of fellow devotees. Accordingly, we went for Darshan and in spite of being Thursday, within 30 minutes, we were in front of Baba. It was thrilling to see him. He was wearing magenta, not purple. But I consoled myself as to me the color seemed purple on TV. After Gurusthan and museum, we returned to the hotel. Everyone went to sleep as they were too tired. I returned to the temple for evening aarti. I would like to mention here that there is a long queue only for the main Samadhi Mandir. If we want to enter the temple compound, Gurusthan, open air theater, courtyard, donation, counters, museum, Parayan hall, Nandadeep, etc., we may enter from other gates anytime without any queue. I always used to enter from gate number 3, which takes straight to the open courtyard, as I could see Baba, side pose, from the open window. This was my favorite place, as I used to sit in the open courtyard and look at him continuously. Somehow, I could not concentrate on Baba while in Samadhi Mandir, as due to heavy crowd. There are hits and pushes all the time as everyone wants to reach near Baba quickly. The best place for me was this open courtyard where no one hits you, pushes you or asks you to hurry. Coming back to day 1, I could attend the evening aarti from the open compound looking at Baba on live TV and night the palki procession and then retired to the hotel. Day 1 ended, but I was restless inside. The reason was the same, that I could not feel this bliss. I was again worried and constantly thinking that Baba doesn't consider me eligible to shower his blessings on me, to experience what others have been experiencing in Shirdi. With all such thoughts and arguments within myself, I slept and woke up suddenly at 4:15 a.m. due to severe pain in my stomach. I went to the washroom and could hear Om Jai Jagadish Hari. Since I was already awake, I decided to go to the temple. I quickly took bath and rushed to the temple and felt lucky that I could attend at least half of the aarti. Baba was looking so serene in orange night dress. Sitting at my usual place, open courtyard, and looking at Baba, I could feel the divinity. Baba was then given Mangalsnan. I have never seen Kakad Aarti and Shej Aarti before, not even back home. So it was astonishing for me to see all this live, though on TV. But I was more than happy to look at Baba undisrupted through that window. I noticed a queue of people on the other side which was getting longer. I don't know why people were standing there as the nectar was seen from this side. Soon I realized, within minutes after the Mangal Snan, a water container was put there and people started to fill bottles. It was holy water from Baba's Mangal Snan. I had read it earlier on some devotee's experience, its importance, and now repented for not being in the queue. I could get a little Charnamrit from another devotee who got a bottle filled but desperately wanted a little of his holy water for myself. Since I was not carrying any bottle with me, it was not possible and the queue was too long too. So I prayed to Baba to get me his holy water next morning, as next day evening we were to start back for Delhi. I came back to my place to look at Sai. Baba was being dressed. The atmosphere was so divine, full of spirituality, bringing very positive vibes to the body. Day was breaking slowly and Baba was being dressed in purple. I was thrilled and could feel my eyes moist. The spiritual connection, which was a carving for perhaps, had started to establish now. Soon I realized that Baba has now accepted me in his court, as today I have come especially for him, unlike yesterday. When we wanted to be refreshed and have lunch first, I could get a leaf of neem tree from Gurustan as well. I still feel sensation when I realize how lucky I have been during this visit, as I could attend all four aartis that day and Kakad and Madhyan Aarti the next day, the day of our departure. Baba had been instructing me to donate food for quite some time. So we have planned to do it on Saturday morning, as it was my father-in-law's Shardh. Baba connected us with a lady named Padmavati. Phone 077-980-28506, who sells murmura, etc. near Chavadi, and she agreed to cook khichdi, which was actually rice pulla with Nutella, and halwa for next day morning. Other devotees who want to donate some food may contact her, as she willingly does that. We needed to pay her the money only, and she arranged everything. Baba also gave us an opportunity to distribute some vada paws to some beggars near Chavdi some evening. There was an old person selling some colorful threads with beads to tie on wrist and insisted me to buy some. I really didn't need any thread, so I was denied. He said that he needed money to eat. So instead of buying any thread, I gave him a plate of vada pav, which we were distributing at that time. He was happy, took the plate and went to the corner to eat. After a few minutes, he came again. Without saying anything, gave me two threads and left. I was so deeply touched by his kind gesture, and if Baba himself came to me and blessed. There are so many blessings to be mentioned. Another very important, which I never forget in my life, is about the bottle for his holy water. I wanted to have a half liter bottle for next day morning. We tried but could not find any half liter mineral water bottle. So I asked my husband to buy a maza or fruity bottle. We did have 1 liter and 2 liter bottles with us, but I didn't want to be greedy. Even one drop of this holy water is so precious, so it should be used as Charnamrit and should be distributed to maximum number of people. I wanted a little for my son, so I was looking for a smaller bottle. We did buy a fruity bottle and I thought of using the same bottle next morning. But later in the evening, while at the vada pav stall, my daughter was thirsty and she noticed a half liter mineral water bottle which I bought for her. The significance of this bottle was realized next day, which I will explain later. While going to bed, I again prayed to Baba to wake me up on time so that I could get the holy water next morning. With Baba's kind grace, I woke up at 3:30 a.m. Saturday, 13th October, which sadly was the day of our departure, and was at Temple Gate at 4 a.m. Since the fruity bottle was still not empty, I had taken with me that half-liter mineral water bottle. I tried to pull off the wrapper, thinking it is not required for Baba's holy water, but it didn't come out. The temple was still not open. The guard asked me to wait for 15 minutes. There were four ladies already there waiting, and I noticed that everyone had 1 liter empty bottle in hands. I joined them and sat beside them. Many people approached the gate after me, but the guard returned them all. And suddenly at 4:10 a.m., he asked for us to go inside. I was the first one to enter the temple. I quickly went to have Baba's first glimpse through my favorite window. Baba was looking awesome in dark green night attire. After his darshan, I went to Gurusthan, which was full with neem leaves. I collected leaves to my heart's content, about 15. There were still lot of leaves scattered, but I left them for others, as I know how all of us strive for getting even one leaf. The other four ladies collected the other leaves. After that, I went straight to the place where the holy water was supposed to come after Mangal Snan. Though the Aarti was yet to begin, and the Mangal Snan was to take place only after Aarti, I did not want to miss this last opportunity. Those ladies called me to come to the courtyard to have first Aarti, but I insisted to stay at the same place. The Aarti started, and I started feeling the bliss. The atmosphere was again so heavenly. I perhaps cannot explain it in words. It can only be felt there. At the end of Kakat Aarti, usually some bhajans are sung. The previous day, the bhajans were same as in the Aarti book, but this particular day, after listening to the bhajans, they started to sing. Thoda dhyan laga sai, daure daure aayenge, akhiya man ki khol tujhe, darshan wo karayenge. This bhajan is very close to my heart, as this is the first bhajan I ever heard about Baba. It was sent to me by my sister from Australia. Actually, my guru sister, as she is not my sister by birth, but we were connected through Baba and he has tied us into relation forever, about 2 years ago. And since that day, this particular bhajan is the ringtone of my bubble. I was already feeling divine, but as soon as this bhajan started, I was out of my senses. Though I remember each word of this bhajan, but I could not sing it alone. My voice choked and tears started rolling. I could not understand whether all this was happening really or it was some very beautiful dream. I don't know in which world I was when someone shook my shoulder and asked me to stand up as the holy water had arrived. Coming back to my senses, I filled my bottle and came to the courtyard to sit with my Baba. Baba was being dressed while getting ready in the morning. I wore a green color suit and I just thought, Baba, I am wearing green today. Would you also win green? However, I realized immediately that Baba was already in green, as he was dressed in green for Shej Aarti the previous night. But the miracles were not yet over. The tears, which I had controlled somehow again, started to roll as I saw that Baba was being dressed in very beautiful green dress again. I was sitting still and just gazing at Baba, thanking a ton for his loving and kind grace. This place, which I always wanted, was flowing and flowing. Time was around 6 a.m. I noticed on TV that Dwarka Mai was empty. So I thought of taking Baba's Darshan there. I went there and noticed the cat sitting in a window between Dwarka Mai and Mukh Darshan Hall. I have read on some devotees' experience that this particular cat stays in Dwarka Mai and someone sits on devotee's lap. I came out but repented that I should have at least touched the cat. I went inside again, patted the cat and left satisfactorily. I returned to the temple from gate number 3 and took my place in the open courtyard and started to talk to him in my thoughts. I once again conveyed all the prayers of my friends, relatives, submitted my personal problems to his holy feet and expressed my heartfelt thanks for accepting me in his court, showing me his presence and arranging everything so beautifully for such a comfortable visit. But I was very sad too, because only few hours left and we were to leave for Delhi. Due to my job, the daily routine back home is so hectic that I do not get enough time to do proper puja. Even the prayers I recite while traveling to office. I was constantly thinking that with the end of this visit, the ananda which was being felt will also come to an end. I will be stuck in my routine immediately, and who knows when we will get a chance to again visit our dear Lord, our Savior. I somehow had same feelings as a newly wedded girl who visits her parents for a short stay and has to leave her parents to go back to her husband's home. Maybe because we had to wait for 4 long years to see our Baba, and this visit seemed too short. I then bought some books from Sansthan's publication and left for the hotel. Upon reaching our room, I noticed that the wrapper of the bottle carrying Baba's holy water read Sai Dhara. I was again touched deeply. Though we had brought a fruity bottle especially for this holy water, but Baba made us buy this small mineral water bottle. On the way to the temple in the morning, I did try to pull off the wrapper without noticing the text, thinking it was not necessary to be bottle, but it not came out. Now I realized why it did not come out. Later, after the noon aarti, we distributed the rice pulao and halwa near Chavdi. We took our last darshan in the Samadhi temple and with heavy hearts took leave from Baba, requesting him to call us again soon. We took our night train on Saturday and reached Delhi on Sunday late evening. Though the visit to Shirdi ended with this, but not his miracles. My husband joined the office next day, that is Monday, and I was supposed to join from Tuesday as I wanted to clear the laundry etc. on Monday. After reaching Delhi, we came to know that my husband's office has arranged Sai Bhajan Sandhya on Monday evening, which was 15th October, Baba's Mahasamadhi Day. Even before my joining the office, before myself getting busy in my hectic daily routine, Baba made sure that I should continue to feel his presence around. He again showed that he listens to even smallest of our prayers too. The Sai Sandhya by singer Pankaj Raj was equally divine. And during that blissful evening, I was again lost in the same bhajan. Thoda Dhyan Laga was started. Closed my eyes and felt as if I was at the same place in temple. Kakad Harti was going on with same divinity and Baba's presence around. I really couldn't ask for more. Even now, when I close my eyes and think about Baba, I see him through the temple's window. Whenever I look at the watch, the first thought which crosses my mind is that what Baba would be doing now. Such an attachment I have never felt before. I have returned to Delhi, but my soul is left somewhere there only. And I pray to Baba to call us again soon, because there is nothing more beautiful in this world than sitting in his temple and gazing at you. Om Sai Ram.
Please visit our blog video.saiyugnetwork.com. For experiences, please visit shirdisaibabaexperiences.org. For stories, please visit shirdisaibabastories.org. For bhajans, please visit shirdisaibabhajans.com. For our Hindi blog, please visit hindiblog.saiyugnetwork.com. For submitting your experiences or prayers, please visit submit.saiyugnetwork.com. For more details, please visit our website saiyugnetwork.com. Please check, we have shared all links in comment sections here as well.
Anant koti brahmand nayak raja dhiraj yogi raj parabrahma Sri Sachidananda Sadguru Sai Nath Maharaj ki jai.